out here splashing around in one of West Virginia's many rivers, and we're looking for hellbenders, and this is one of the things that they eat, although this is a very large crayfish, and I imagine it would take a very large hellbender to eat something like this.
This is another good example of something else you might find when you're out playing in a creek. These guys, the northern water snakes, they right now it's the middle of July, so they are in the water. We actually flipped this one under a rock in the water. Take a good look at that guy. That's a really interesting looking one. He's got really cool contrasting colors. I mean, even if these things are super common, he's a really cool looking snake. Check that out. Pretty cool. I'm gonna throw this right back in the water.
All right, I want to be ready for this. We just flipped a nearby rock and we just had a big hellbender swim out from under it and he went right under here. So I'm hoping we can get this on film. I didn't even have the net in my hand. I don't know what I was thinking, but we're gonna see if we can get him. I'm not sure which way he's facing, but we're gonna see.
Oh, geez. I'm gonna go really slow because we know he's under here. Oh my God. Look at the size of that salamander. Oh, he's getting out the back. He's getting out the back of the rock. Oh no, where'd he go? Oh no, I just lost him. Oh, he just scooted. I think he's right by my foot again.
Nope, he's right by my foot.
Oh, he's right by Desiree's foot. He's right there. Oh, let me get him. Do you see him? Oh my God, where'd he go?
He's now
right there. He's getting away. He went right back towards that rock.
Oh yeah, here he is. Oh my God. Oh, look at that. Wow.
We are down on one of West Virginia's many rivers today. And I just found one of the largest salamanders, not only that I've ever held, but the largest salamander native to North America, the Eastern Hellbender. I've got him right here in this net. I'm gonna pick him up. I wanna keep him in the water because they use the flaps in their skin to breathe. They like these nice cold high oxygen rivers that have, you know, plentiful crayfish for them to eat. And I'm gonna hold this thing up. This thing is beautiful. Like, you know, a lot of people would argue that fact with me because it's a big slimy brown monster. He's gonna be hard to get a hand on. I don't want to give him the death grip, but wow, what an amazing creature. Come here. This is the Eastern Hellbender. We're gonna let him go right back in the net. I just wanted to hold him up so you get a better look at him. But wow, these things are strong too. Check this beast out. I mean, what makes this such a great river is that prey is plentiful for these Eastern Hellbenders, and the water for the most part is still relatively clean. It has been, for the most part, it's at such a high elevation and there hasn't been much development in this area that these big guys have rivers that aren't really full of silt due to construction. Oop, I don't want to lose them. Come on.
So here we are with two more Eastern Hellbenders. This one's really cool. He's got black spots. We flipped these guys almost back to back, so I wanted to share these guys with you. Now, not only do these guys face threats in the form of pollution and habitat degradation, but they're also vulnerable to the amphibian diseases. They are not immune to chytrid, the deadly fungus that's wiping out amphibians in many places around the world. And in some populations of hellbenders, they're also seeing lots of like open red sores on their bodies. They're also finding some with limb loss, and they believe it's not from them fighting each other, but it's actually like a bacterial infection. So hopefully that, you know, the scientists can figure out what is exactly going on with these beautiful animals. But I can't tell you how excited I am that we were able to get out here today in this beautiful river in wild and wonderful West Virginia and see these animals. Just how amazing is this?
All right, little hellbender, back home with you. It was fun getting to meet you. And we're right back under where we found you.
Like what you're seeing? Click here to join us as we uncover more fantastic reptiles and amphibians in our home state of Maryland, or check out the action in my Neverending Herping series. Be sure to subscribe to the Sharing the Outdoors and Neverending Herping channels so you won't miss our next releases, or visit our website, camelchairproductions.com, and be sure to like our Facebook page to see all of our latest content and updates.